something's annual, sort of annual, Kent State, here at the Kent State Center, Rojo. And
all right. Woo! Boy, isn't this a great turnout?
They're all here.
This is great. This is really great.
Well, we've all got to be somewhere, I suppose. Okay, we have a couple of announcements for you, just to give you some how this is going to work kind of stuff. And when we get done with our announcements, we'll tell you who's coming on first. We'll have the opening prayer, and right after the prayer, we'll start with the road shows. So are we all excited about that?
Yeah. Whoa.
Dave, you've got the written down announcements?
I got the announcements. I got the written down ones here?
Yeah.
All right. A couple of things we'd like to ask you to do this evening. If you have to leave for any reason, please use the two back doors. And if there's any children that seem to have any problems with really not liking the show too much, and they have to cry a whole lot, we'd like to ask you to take them out in the hallway for just a little bit. Also, we'd really like you to take note of our great judges that we have here this evening. I think they can be bribed, but I'm not sure about that. Yeah, any leftover Halloween candy? Okay.
Looks like they'll take just about anything. So.
Yeah. All right, was there anything else here? I think that's about it.
Okay, I have a couple of unwritten announcements, so I'm not really reading anything here. If you have the programs, we don't have quite enough for both nights, so if you're don't need it as a souvenir, would you please, at the end of the show, there's boxes up front, if you just return them so we can use them again tomorrow night. Also, timing is very important in the road shows, and one of the things that the youth will be judged on is finishing their road show within the specified time limit. Now this is in your interest as well, because otherwise it just goes on and on and on. So I told you that to tell you, so don't clap during the performance, wait till they're done. Give them one big round of applause, but if you clap during the performance, it's just going to slow it down. They're going to miss their time marks. They'll be angry with you, and they'll behave like teenagers. So, so don't do that. Dave and I, Dave Keene, Paul Anderson, we're MCs tonight. We will be coming up between acts to give them a chance to change the scenery backstage. Dave and I work at the girls' camp. They said, who in the stake has the least dignity of anybody in the whole stake?
Who likes to be embarrassed?
Yeah. So we thought we'd share the wealth tonight, so we're going to ask for volunteers from the audience to assist us in the various preparations. Now, because of this timing thing, we're going to have to get the volunteers for the next break the time before, so we'll be calling out for volunteers. Now, I realize many of you may be reluctant to volunteer. That's okay, because it's okay to volunteer somebody else. Okay, and they're easy things. They don't involve anything that would be potentially embarrassing or difficult or humiliating.
No, nothing at all.
We don't do that. So, have we covered everything?
I think so.
Okay. Who's first?
Well, actually, should we have our opening prayer?
Let's tell them who it is and then have
the
prayer.
Okay, we'd like to have Brother Hanby come up and he'll give us our opening prayer.
And tell them what the act is.
Oh, act, excuse me.
Yeah.
Excuse me, sorry. You've got those notes.
I hope I do. First up will be the 7th Ward, and they will be presenting Phil and Ned's excellent seminary adventure. So be prepared for that. We'll turn the time over to Brother Hanby for an invocation, and then we'll allow the 7th Ward to come on stage.
Our Father in heaven, we're thankful that we can gather this evening and participate in viewing the road shows, and we're thankful for the gospel of Jesus Christ in our lives. We're thankful for the opportunity the youth have to perform these road shows and for all the practice that they've gone through and the adult leaders that have helped them so much. And we pray that they might be blessed to be able to perform as they would desire and feel good about the presentation they're giving. Help us to be helpful to appreciate their efforts and that we might enjoy everything that goes on this evening. We pray for this in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Albert. And of course his best friend Nedrick is there too. They are two guys, always in trouble. They need to get a clue in the story from the future. There are two girls as cute as they can be, and they tell the boys to get ready. They both need to pass their memory.
Sometimes it takes a lot to show somebody the light within. Take, for example, Philbert S. Duncan Esquire and Nedrick Dean Johnson III. These boys have a lot to learn about themselves. Their lights are starting to fizzle. It takes an adventure to show them what they have to offer. In fact, these boys end up being a phenomenal pair of missionaries, but I don't want to give it away. I'll let you see for yourself.
Teacher, we have learned a lot of greatly momentous facts about our church's history.
Yeah, we feel totally confident that we know everything we need to know.
Yeah.
Good, so you're ready for your makeup presentation tomorrow?
Yeah. But what were we supposed to presentate?
Boys, I asked you to pick an important event in the history of the church and tell us how that event is an important part of our church today. Can you handle that?
That is very bodacious of you, most superior teacher.
But tell us again, why is it important that we must pass seminary?
Besides the fact that my dad would kill me.
Boys, the things you have learned in seminary will be important tools as you serve your mission. Let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father in heaven.
And his name shall be called.
Dude, I bet you goes through a lot of Kleenexes.
Boys, I'll see you tomorrow. Make me proud.
Phil, dude, we are totally in distress.
Totally, man, but why is it important that we must pass seminary?
Besides the fact that my dad would kill me. What's that noise?
Whoa!
Ah!
Dude,
rude, most bodacious babes! Who are you?
And where did you come from? Cause I'm there!
Dude! We're sisters from the future. And like our entire lives depend on you two. Oh, your hair is so cute! Not everyone is lucky enough to have what you have.
So like, learn all you can. You'll be glad, okay?
Yeah, good luck on your journey. Check you later. In the future.
Dude, those totally righteous babes need us.
Yeah, I know. We can't disappoint them.
Whoa, look what it says on the booth here. It says all we gotta do is dial a time in history, and we're there.
Dude, pick a digit.
23, man. Michael Jordan's jersey number. I wanna be like Mike. Let's go.
It is March 17th, 1842. Phil and Ned land in the middle of the First Relief Society meeting of the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints. They are about to witness an important event in church history.
I am Edmund P. Johnson III!
And I am Milman S. Duncan, Esquire!
Take us to your leader!
I've always wanted to say that.
Whoa! You're like a famous righteous lady! We're not worthy! We're not worthy!
Boys, get off the ground! That is not necessary, I assure you! Where did these two come from?
From the future! We're here to gather important information about our church's history!
From the future, huh? If you believe that, I have a lake full of salt to sell you.
Listen! We are in trouble. Can't you help us?
Now you're talking.
You've come to the right place.
Yes, that is what we do. We are the Relief Society at your service.
Yeah.
Let us tell you a story that we are sure you can use for your report.
Back in the seminary class, Phil and Ned are wrapping up their presentation.
And that, my fellow classmates, yeah, is the story of the coming forth of the Book of Mormon and the founding of the Relief Society, without which we would not have little frilly objects and centerpieces and potluck dinners, baby!
Yeah! In conclusion, I'd like to say that it is one of the oldest female organization in the world.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Boys, that was wonderful. It was as if you were actually there. Class, let's have donuts.
Yeah.
So now you see what it took to turn Phil and Ed into totally righteous dudes. Their testimonies kept on growing after their adventure, where they were called to serve missions in Florida. And they are now serving as companions. Who would have thought?
Elder, we've been tracking all day, and no one's letting us in.
Don't they know we have so much to offer?
It's got plenty.
But who cares? No big deal. They want more. They wanna know why we pipe all day. Cars are required for sisters, pansies, running around the heart.
What's that word again?
Sleeping in late, you don't get too far. Rules are required to keep the spirit.
Thank you.
Boy, I was sure impressed.
That was nice. That was very nice.
That was excellent.
Very nice.
Ah, excellent.
Excellent.
Excellent, hey.
Excellent, dude.
Hey.
All right, we need a couple of volunteers for this one. Joe Conrad said he'd come on up. And Kathleen.
Where's Kathleen
Utterback?
Come on,
she's
Kathleen.
A volunteer.
Come on out, Kathleen, wherever
really
you are.
It's really easy. We have the words written down for you. All you have to do is sing them. Okay?
Where's Kathleen?
Where's Kathleen?
We can collect volunteers. You can nominate volunteers for the next one.
I don't know, I can't find her. She said she wouldn't hide.
She's where? There she is.
All right, all right.
All right, hit it, Joe.
Come on up.
Here's your words. You're Jane.
We really got to sing.
He's breeze. He's always at ease. He lives in the jungle and hangs by his knees as he swings through the trees without a trapeze in his BBD. He's got a union card and he's practicing hard to play the guitar. Gonna be a big star, yeah, he's gonna go far and carry moonbeams home in a jar. He ordered Chet's guitar core, COD, makes A and E and he's working on B. Dig C and W and R and B and me and a chimpanzee agree that one day soon he'll be a celebrity. Get it, get it, get it, get it, ow, guitar's in. He's a guitar man. He's all you can stand. Give him a hand, Guitar Zan. He's got a girl named Jane with no last name, kinda homely and plain, but he loves her just the same, cause she kindles a flame and it drives him insane when he hears her sing. She really does her thing, it's her claim to fame. Come on, sing one, Jane. He likes to get drunk and sing boogie woogie and it sounds real funky. Come on, your time, boy. Sing one, monkey. Here we go. Let's hear it for the monkey. On Saturday night, they need some excitement. Jane gets right and the monkey gets tight and their voices unite in the pale moonlight and it sounds all right. Yeah, it's dynamite. It's out of sight, let's hear it right now.
Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you.
We need three men to volunteer for next time.
Oh, Sammy.
Jamie?
Yeah.
Okay, that's one. Come on. Well, don't come up now. Come up as soon as they finish the next one. Who else?
Hank?
Hey? Hank, all right. All right, come on.
Good.
Up.
All right. He's up next.
What? They're ready?
Thank you. missed the bus.
I know, but I got one of those lectures again. All I wanted was a room to my own. My mom started with, when I was a kid, I shared a room with 10 brothers and sisters. Those were the good old days.
My parents get down on my music. They say their music had a beat. Disco.
Yeah, my parents had to do digital school because they didn't have photocopiers.
My mom actually had to learn to multiply because they didn't have calculators.
What amazes me is they think those were the good old days.
Let's move along now.
We
Rome, a girl named Cleopatra liked to call the place her home. Her father was a pharaoh, and Rome they called her friend. That is until her father met his very bitter end. Her fun and games were over, she had to settle down. Queen was now her title, on the throne she was found. In the middle of her glory, Egypt was within her grasp. Cleo found that she was bitten by an ugly, scaly snake. As the pyramids began to crumble and the dynasty slipped away, her lips softly uttered,
"How about them good old days?"
The marshal saw him and rounds were fired. Jesse knew
to expire. Oh, no.
Oh, yes.
The sheriff said these words were his last.
Them good old days of fame are past.
Yeah, wasn't the second ward great? They were really good.
That was really something, wasn't it?
I don't think I'd want to be one of these poor judges down here that's going to have to decide.
What do we got?
Yes, the word.
Bread and butter. This is a lovely story of a perfect romance gone bad. Hank here is our lead singer, and these two are our backup. Now, you don't have to actually sing unless you want to. Okay. We're ready. You guys start. We'll give you a little help here.
Who start? The backup start?
The backup start.
Oh, okay.
He likes bread and butter. He likes toast and jam. Oh, that's what his baby feeds him. He's a loving man.
Well, I like bread and butter. Yeah.
them go. For our next one, we're going to need three female singers. Do you have any suggestions?
Susan Olsen!
There's one. Sarah? Okay. Sandra Johnson. That sounds like three people to me.
Hey, let's thank these guys. They really did a great job. Yeah.
Woo, we knew they could do it. We knew they could. Hey. And don't think you're getting off light. We have a couple of audience participation ones for everybody to be part of. So, who's next, Dave?
Third Ward.
Are we ready?
Is Third Ward ready? I think they're pretty close.
Was that a yes?
Yes,
Third Ward's ready. The title of their show is We All Like Sheep. And we happen to know Third Ward is one of the best wards in the state, one of the nine best wards in the state. So.
Sounds like ink. Used ink.
What do they want? Why are they attacking? Why? Why? Why?
Over there on the right. Get them.
I got you covered, buddy. It's working! They're leaving!
Winslow.
Buford, you may call me Dr. Morton.
Sorry.
Now, the reason the aliens are attacking us, I believe, is a result of a simple chain of events.
Really? Tell us, Dr. Morton. Winslow?
Do you remember what the aliens were saying during the attack?
Yeah, they were saying something about ink, weren't they, Buford?
Yes. Used ink.
Do you think someone wrote a really nasty note using a really cheap pen? No. What I believe in reality what the aliens were saying was you stink.
It's not me.
No, not you personally. Buford, Selena, the Earth is polluting space with a terrible stench.
Well, how could this happen?
Miss Winsome, there's developed a hole in the atmosphere.
The sky is falling?
In a way, yes.
Well, what caused this?
A chemical imbalance.
What chemical?
Methane gas.
Methane gas from what?
Sheep. Billions of sheep.
From cloning?
Precisely.
That's enough to make my head spin.
My head is spinning.
Well, what can we do to stop this?
We must travel back into time and stop the development of sheep cloning. Luckily,
I have invented a time machine for just such a purpose.
What time period are we traveling back to?
Back to the late 70s and early 80s, when the first experimentation with sheep cloning took place.
Ah, the 70s. A simpler time. A gentler time. Oh well, dress time.
My research indicates that a high school senior named Gregory Brady made the first experimentation with sheep cloning on November 9th, 1978. If we can stop him, we can save the Earth.
Greg Brady? We're gonna see Greg Brady? I can't wait to see Greg Brady. You're the greatest doctor on the south of the Earth. When do we go?
Right now. We've no time to lose.
Wait. If we're going back to the 70s, we have to dress to fit in.
When living in the 70s, you can't be dull like Lint. Wear olive green and yellow with flowers in the print. Wear it like a pro. Just like a fashion show.
Got to look just right.
Big hair.
Platform shoes.
And polyester white. Wear it like a pro. Now we've got to go.
Wait, before we go, I must tell you. The time machine will automatically bring us back to 2017, as soon as we've prevented the crisis. Remember, we've got to stop Greg Brady from cloning that first sheep. Now, go!
March to Brady, too. That would be awesome.
You've heard. We're here to save the Earth, not to flirt with pretty girls.
Correct you are, Miss Winsome. Now we must find that Brady boy.
Hey, that guy over there can tell me where they live. Excuse me, sir. I was wondering, would you happen to know where the Brady family lives?
Get down, baby. What's happening?
Well, I think what I'm asking you is if you know where the Brady family
No, I mean, get down. What's going on? What's the story?
Excuse me, Miss Winsome. I believe this gentleman is speaking Disconics, a short-lived language of the late 70s and early 80s. It was widely used among the listeners of disco, an unpleasant music style at the time. Let me try speaking with him. Hey, man, what's happening? We need to jet to the Brady pad. We need to get down with Greg Brady.
Cool. The Brady pad is right there, man. You can't miss it. Just wait for the grooving tune. Say, who's the hot babe? She's one fine chick.
I think I'm catching on. Okay, my name is Selena Winsome, Macho Man. What's the story on the grooving tune?
Hold the phone, cheeky. It's starting up right now.
Here's the story of a lovely lady who was bringing up great, very lovely girls. All of them had hair of gold, like their mother, the youngest one in curls.
It's the story of a man named Brady, who was busy with three boys of his own. They were four then, living all together, yet they were all alone.
Till the one day when the lady met this fellow.
much more than a hunch. That in this group must somehow form a family. That's the way we all became the Brady Bunch. The Brady Bunch. The Brady Bunch. That's the way we became the Brady Bunch.
Marcia, Marcia, Marcia.
Well, you kids do your homework. I'm gonna go help your mother with dinner.
Oh, Mike.
Does anybody want to help me with my science project?
I do!
Oh, yes, Greg. That will be so nice.
What's it about, Greg?
Well, I'm trying to clone a sheep with this cloning gun I made from scraps in Dad's garage. I think it will work. Alice let me try it on some of her meatloaf, and then double.
That sounds cool, Greg. How can we help?
Well, Bobby, you and Peter can go get an extension cord so we can charge it up. And Cindy, you can get a place ready for the sheep. And Marcia, you can bring the sheep in.
Why does Marcia get to bring in the sheep? Marcia, Marcia, Marcia. She always gets the best jobs.
Now, Jen, I have a special job in mind for you.
Oh, you do, Greg? What is it?
Here. Take this and walk behind the sheep. You'll know what to do.
Thanks, Greg.
Excuse me, young man. My name is Dr. Winslow Moore. I'm a messenger from the future. Here to ask you to stop this cloning project. It will have grave consequences.
I can't. I have to pass my science class. And if I don't pass my science class, Dad says he won't let me drive the station wagon for a whole month.
Boy, I'm talking about the end of the world here. You must not go through with this.
I'm sorry, sir. I just can't be without a car. I have a date next week with a really groovy chick.
For the love of mankind, Frank, think of someone other than yourself. This is your future here, your children's future, your children's children's future. We're talking the end here. It could be a terrible, hurtful, painful end. You just have to stop. You just have to.
He's not listening, Miss Winsome. I guess you win some and you lose some.
Why, you? Make Selena cry, will you? I got it. I got the gun.
Oh, no, you don't.
About to clone the sheep, beginning the horrible chain of events which brings the aliens' attack on Earth. But can I really stand by and allow this to happen? After all, what if Greg Brady's aim isn't that good?
Now I'll finish!
I've been shot. Not cool, man.
I can't believe it! Greg missed the sheep!
He hit the disco guy instead!
Get down! Get down! What's happening, man?
It's the time machine! It's pulling us back! We must have prevented the crisis!
He saved you! Come on!
Marcia! Marcia! Marcia!
But the disco guy! It troubles me! I wonder...
Moon across the floor, we will dance and dance some more.
to the good old days and save the earth from alien ways. Now in our beds, we safely sleep, but next to disco, we all like sheep.
We all like sheep. Moving across the floor, we will dance and dance more. In the now, way back when, it's disco, it never ends. It never ends, it never ends, it never ends.
Wars!
Wars!
Who else did we have? Sandra? Okay.
Come on up.
Come on up. Let me just work with the lights.
Is she really going out with me?
Well, there she is. Let's ask her.
Betty, is that Jimmy's ring you're wearing?
You can do this.
Gee, it must be great riding with him.
Is he picking you up after school today?
Oh,
By the way, where'd you meet him?
I met him at the candy store. He turned around and smiled at me. You get the picture?
Yes, we see.
That's when I fell for
leader of the pack.
That was terrific. The next one is that we're all going to participate. We'll be handing out song sheets during the performance here of the Kent 8th Ward, the true ward in the stake. No bias here. We'll let Dave do 6th Ward. Presenting Mother Goose Tales.
Until tomorrow. The house is kind of a mess, and...
Mother?
If you can't control that Georgie Porgy kid, I am so sick and tired of him sneaking up behind me and playing those wet smooches on my cheeks. My lawyer says the grand case is set...
We have company.
Say, how are all of you? When did they get here? I thought they weren't coming till tomorrow.
Hi, Honk.
The name is Peep.
Honk to Beep, whatever. Has the guy from Terminix showed up yet? There's so many spiders around here, I can't get a bite to eat.
Miss Muff has only been looking for somebody new. Ever since Peter put in that pumpkin shell, she's been spitting seeds.
All right, you two. Well, why don't you go find three or four more sheep and I'll drop by later.
As for you, little Miss Muffet, you can't keep calling the bug killer every time you think you see a spider. And I've told the market you're not allowed to charge any more cans of Raid.
But, Mom!
Not another word. I have visitors to attend to.
That's another thing. Every time I sit down to eat, there's somebody peeking in the window to see that stupid old spider scare my curds away. It ain't no peep show.
Enough, dear. I'll drop by later.
So sorry you all had to see and hear that. Life in Gooseland is wonderful. You aren't buying this, are you? Well, would you like to see what it is really like? When you all close the book, these characters really come to life. You know that fellow Jack in the house he built? I'll tell you, it's rat-a-tat-tat with the hammer and saws going night and day. For as many years as he's been building, he could have rebuilt New York. Come with me and you'll see.
On his wall, he's trying to see.
break from that repetitious life we lead.
I heard old Humpty Dumpty say he was longing for the good old life before happily ever after.
He said he had no idea that ever after meant all the time after.
Yeah, over and over again.
Have you ever been invited to the palace to eat with the king? Every single time, the same old thing. Blackbird.
Go! Go!
No matter what he orders, it always comes up Blackbird. He was sure yearning for something else to eat like we had in the good old days.
If that old cow brags about how utterly tickled she is to be able to jump in the moon, I'll...
Speaking of cows, you know what you call a cow with no legs?
No.
No. What do you call a cow with no legs?
Grumpy.
Your jokes are getting really old.
Don't blame us. We're only trying to break the monotony.
Yo, Jack, we still having that shindig tonight?
You bet your cows are our blue boy. On contrary, Mary and I are hip to cut a rug, Dave.
Speaking of Mary, have you ever tasted that crop of corn from that woman's garden? It's to die for. Crocker shells are no, she can certainly make things grow.
Hey guys, what's up?
Wait, hold on. Was that Georgie kid invited?
As far as I know, the whole Rhymers Association's gonna be there. Why?
Well, you know how the toughest Muffet feels about him.
Yeah, I think she's only playing hard to get.
Wouldn't you know it, the men are all like that broken crown fellow I once fell for.
Ain't it true, Jill? They think we girls stand for nothing but being chased by them.
Well, I don't mind all that much. Besides, I like to swing and dance. Or is it dance the swing?
Well, we men.
Men!
Yes, yes. Men.
We got a few diversions when the goose's mother ain't looking.
Just what do you do when you sneak out of here?
You know.
Did you know there was a party tonight?
Shh. Yeah, we did.
Well, I just found out.
It's only gonna be us anyway. The men are gonna be playing ball.
We are the men of Goosetails, the hippest cats around.
If you don't stop, your heads will pop and your brains will never be found.
It's part routine in Gooseland. We gotta change the pace.
Okay, by us, why all of us don't make it all a race? Oh, can't you see how happy we could be if you would only do and be true to you?
We'd like to play that way, but the sun's out today. Hope it's okay, the game starts right away.
It's just that we've been rhymers for 900 years.
We'll all be signed to do short time and not waste our careers.
Mother Goose has a racket by gluing us to our page.
The dough she earns is enough to earn while we can't even act our age.
Oh, can't you see how happy we could be if you would only do and be true to you?
We'd like to play that way, but the sun's out today. Hope it's okay, the game starts right away.
Typical men, someone will fall down a hill and they'll walk away to the game.
Dang it!
Well, you know, with all the excitement here in Gooseland, seeing the same old people doing the same old thing every day, we need a break, don't you think?
Speaking of breaks, Siri is the class crown.
Well, I think he's kind of cute.
Well, Betty, don't be blue. Let the music play and let's see what you can do.
Jump, 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 jump
all been having a great old time. Maybe it's time to get back to the nursery rhyme grind.
It's getting kind of old hat, don't you think? Seeing the same thing, just a different day.
It's not that bad, you know?
You do have to admit that sitting on a tuffet all day is tedious.
Now, little miss. Just you remember how many children enjoy your rhymes. When they hear those word patterns of mine, to take them back to the good old days.
Which good old days?
Why, the ones when they were children thought nothing but having fun and enjoying life. That is why we stay up here on these pages.
To remind them of the days when they were younger.
And to create those same days for their children.
Speaking of... Would somebody be so kind to tell me what a tuffet is?
Boy, it's been a pretty good evening so far, hasn't it?
We passed out song sheets, so we all get to participate in this one. The words are easy, but they go a little fast, so just keep up as best you can. It's real easy. Those of you who have been to girls' camp last year will recognize the tune, so we'll hit it. Starts out kind of quiet.
Constantinople, now it's Istanbul, now Constantinople, been a long time gone. Constantinople, now it's Turkish delight on a moonlit night. Every gal in Constantinople lives in Istanbul, now Constantinople, so if you've a date in Constantinople, she'll be waiting in Istanbul. Even old New York was once New Amsterdam. Why they changed it, I can't say. People just liked it better that way. So take me back to Constantinople. No, you can't go back to Constantinople. Been a long time gone. Constantinople, why did Constantinople get the works? That's nobody's business but the Turks. Istanbul. Even old New York was once New Amsterdam. Why they changed it, I can't say. People just liked it better that way. Istanbul was Constantinople, now it's Istanbul. Now Constantinople, been a long time gone. Now Constantinople, why did Constantinople get the works? That's nobody's business but the Turks. Constantinople, no you can't go back to Constantinople. Been a long time gone. Constantinople, why did Constantinople get the works? That's nobody's business but the Turks. Istanbul.
Well, that was only fair. You guys would never make it at girls' camp. They'd throw you out the first night. You'd have to sleep in Easton. Ooh, okay.
Oh, guess who's up next?
Oh, that ward.
Yeah.
Oh, is that ward ready?
Is the sixth ward ready? I think so.
They're ready.
All right. On with the show.
There. What's the name of theirs? The sixth ward, Sentimental Journey.
A man talking to himself in the forest with no women around to hear him, is he still wrong?
If a man with split personalities threatens to kill himself, is it a hostage situation?
If a turtle doesn't have a shell, is he naked or homeless?
Why do kamikaze pilots wear helmets?
Can vegetarians eat animal crackers?
Everybody sway, lean to the left. Everybody lean to the right. I just wanted to sway the crowd.
A friend, and your grandpa was my older brother's best friend.
So he was always there? And I tell you, with that many children, our cookout was always an adventure.
Delicious dinner that we're going to have. Who has the food?
Well, I've got the hot dogs, Dad.
Great. So who has the rest of the food?
It was in the orange crate by our back door.
Dad! Dad! Pick me, I know this one, awesome.
Yeah.
I brought the orange crate to the car, and you told me I need it, so I took it back in your house for you.
Well, that's okay. Think of how good those hot dogs have tasted, cooked over an open fire. Now, who has the matches?
Dad! Dad! Come on, Dad! Right here,
somebody?
Dad! Dad!
Anybody?
Dad! Pick me, Dad!
Yeah.
When I brought the orange crate and I took it to my house, I saw the matches in there. So we don't have matches either.
I'm going home.
Oh, that's okay. Hot dogs are one of the few foods that are mighty tasty right out of the bag.
We have the sticks to roast the hot dogs, Dad.
Believe me, Roger, we won't need them.
Oh, Grandma, is this your skirt?
Yes, I wore that the first time your grandpa asked me out on a date.
So, Dottie, has Bill asked you to the dance yet?
No.
You know he likes
you.
Do you think? And I know he wants to ask you to the dance.
I sure hope so.
So, Bill, have you asked Dottie to the dance yet?
No.
Cute chicken, you know she likes you. Go ask her now.
Oh.
Hi, Bill.
Hi, Dottie. I was wondering.
Yes?
Well, on Friday night, there's a...
A dance.
Yeah, and, well, I was thinking maybe you and I could...
Go to the dance together? Oh, Bill, I'd love to. Thanks so much for asking me.
We'll be right back.
Is this your wedding bell?
Oh, yes. I wore that the day your grandpa and I got married in the Salt Lake City Temple.
Oh, did you have a wedding reception, Grandma?
I did, and your grandpa and I waltzed together for the very first time.
Oh.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, to the lovely lilting tones of the Sondheim sisters, the newlyweds, William and Dorothy, will have their first waltz together as husband and wife.
While they're taking those down, we forgot to get volunteers, so we have one already. Laura Barris already volunteered. Laura? Oh.
All right,
Okay.
Come on out.
Thank you.
Hey.
There's an element of payback in this that goes back, I don't know. Take it up with Kathleen. We need three others. Come on up. Two more. This young man right here looks very eager. Yes, you.
Come on down. Or up.
All right, the good news is this one, the words are really easy. You don't even have to sing if you don't want to. It's more of a dance contest.
Will you volunteer? Your hand was up. I want to dance. That's what it said. All right, let's roll.
When everybody's heard about the bird. Bird. It's a winner, well a bird, bird, bird. Bird is a winner, well a bird, bird, bird. Well a bird is a winner, well a bird, bird, bird. The bird's a winner, well a bird, bird, bird. Well a bird is a winner, well a bird, bird. The bird's a winner, well a bird, bird, bird. The bird's a winner, well a bird, bird, bird. Well a bird is a winner, well a bird, bird. The bird's a winner, well a don't you know about the bird? Well everybody knows that the bird is a winner, well a bird, bird. The bird's a winner, well a.
Thank you.
Seven.
Okay, we'll let you go. Thanks for being such good sport.
I think so.
Okay, there's been a little change. First ward is going to move ahead of fifth ward in the program, so we'll start with first ward, and I forgot what comes next for us there. Oh, we don't need volunteers, but you remember how well these people danced up here? Get used to it, because you're all up next. How you, Jim?
Good to see you. Haven't seen you since grade school.
Yeah, it's been a long time. Thanks. Got it at Nordstrom's. Yeah. It's an Italian brand.
You're always a good dresser, even when you're young.
Yeah, we were. You know, when we were young, we were already dressed for success.
So.
Hey, Jim, where'd you say your cousin got these clothes from?
Something like Woodstock.
Is that in North or South America?
I'm not sure.
Yeah, we were pretty sharp back then. Sharp dressers.
Yeah, we were. Yeah, we had good hair, you know. Remember how well we kept our hair?
Yeah, we kept our hair pretty nice back then.
Yeah, we really looked good.
What was that stuff we just put on our hair?
I don't know. I lost the bottle.
I think we used a little too much.
Yeah, we were pretty sharp back then.
Sure were. Hey, reading the Wall Street Journal, I see still. You know, there is no surprise at all that you're so successful in business, because back when we were in grade school, starting in grade school, you were always the put the nose to the grindstone type of guy.
Yeah, I was a pretty serious student back then. I learned to apply myself early.
Right, I did too.
I wonder why.
Why would they want to see these? All mine has written on it is the letter F.
Same with mine. That must mean fantastic.
Cool.
Yeah, we were pretty sharp back then.
Yeah. What do you think about the music nowadays?
Oh, they're not, I don't know, the songs aren't as good as when we were young.
No, I don't think so either.
There's some pretty good ones out
now. Yeah, we had some good music.
Hey, look at it. Listen to this new song on the radio.
I already heard it on my brother's 8-track.
That song we used to dance to. It's on the tip of my tongue.
You know, I don't remember. It's kind of funny. We remember everything else about our youth so accurately, but we can't remember the title of a song.
Right. Well, you know, at least we remember the important stuff.
Yeah. Yeah, I gotta get going.
I
it's good
too.
Seeing you, Jim.
Yeah, it's good seeing you. See you later.
Change, 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 change dancing, but boy, oh boy, those boys, they just bring me back to the day. Oh my goodness.
A three.
Oh, the longest for the longest time. Oh, the longest for the longest.
Hey, 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 hey
I see some people sitting down. They're bad people.
Come on, let's go.
They told me they need a little extra time to set up, so we'll do the whole thing. While they're finishing setting up here, if you want to, you can ask your bishop for that in sacrament meeting, but maybe if you want a new bishop. I don't know. Speaking of bishops, we need volunteers for the next deal. So if your first name is Bishop,
yeah.
Yeah. Or say President,
that'd be good too. Yeah.
We'll have you come on up for the but not right now, but as soon as they're finished, as soon as we're finished, does this mean they're ready?
I don't know, but they're kicking me off the stage here. I don't know.
So if now it'll be 10th ward. What's that? I'm being pushed now. Okay, I guess it's time to start. 10th ward, the good old days.
To a place with a beach and no school. doesn't look like you're very interested in this project.
I don't believe there is such thing as time travel.
When I was your age, I didn't believe in it either. But back in the good old days when I was on my mission, second thought, boys, I don't think you're ready to hear about it.
Hear about what?
Yeah, tell us.
We're Boy Scouts. We're prepared to hear anything.
Well, all right, but you gotta be careful who you share this with. Because some folks just won't believe it. But there we were. Elder Jones and me out on our mission to the Isle of Sea.
Why is it, Elder Smith, that we were sent to the Isles of the Sea when there's no one out here that wants or needs to hear our message? We have a boat full of copies of the Book of Mormon, and not a single investigator. My time out here is wasted, and I'm just about ready to go back to the good old days from before my mission. There's no point to all this island searching. Nothing ever comes of it. Nothing ever happens.
Maybe nothing ever happens because you don't put your flippin' oar in the water.
What could it hurt to give faith a try?
What's all this, Elder?
I don't know. I've never seen anything like it. And the time on my watch is going backwards.
Just sit right back and you'll hear a tale of a fateful trip that started from this tropic morning aboard this tiny ship. The ship set ground on the shore of this uncharted desert isle. With Gilligan, the skipper too.
Whoa, Elder, this is weird, dude.
Look, a boat, a boat. Have you come to save us?
I've come here with a message that will save you.
This boat's too small to fit us all. Where have you come from?
This is Elder Smith, and I'm Elder Jones. We're from the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints. We have a message to share with the whole island.
A message? Well, that will have to wait, because now the Island Diva and Hula Dancers are here to dance for us.
Woohoo!
Girls!
Check out the hooks. Go get them, girl.
Quick, defend yourself, Elder.
What's this?
Take one of these and call me in the morning.
What is this? Headhunters, let's get out of here.
Read it.
Read it, Louise.
Let's get out of here. No, not that way. Over here.
Wait for me. Me too.
Mr. Howell is right. We can't keep running away forever. We need to come face to face to these neighbors of ours and present a mutually agreeable plan for sharing the island. I'm sure they'll see the logic in it.
Just call it a down payment.
Not good. You must end this urban sprawling, which encroaches upon our land.
Quick, I got it! Grab your scriptures and let's go! Here you go.
What this now?
I saw that you were a little hungry and,
And whosoever partakes of it shall not hunger, but shall have everlasting life.
This must be the book we've been starving for. Why didn't you just say so?
Now there's peace on this island. You have brought something that saved us. This book has saved us.
We're totally complete. Never was a quitter. Battles like a typhoon. We've got the book. Heavenly round. The Lord's got a number. Well, he's sending us around. We gotta teach another. Running from a headhunter. We've got the book. We've got the book.
She's got the book.
We've got the book.
She's got the book.
We're on this island.
I can stand the light and point of view. When everything will ever do is teach the truth. And we go la 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 la. We got the book.
We have our volunteers report to the front. Bishop Mockatel, Sister Dance said she'd hold the kids.
I know they're out there. Come on up.
Oh, we wouldn't humiliate you. We do, however, need one extra. And we promised Sister Mary O'Neill that she could be a part of the program.
That's right. That's right.
And so if she would come out, please.
I think she's hiding behind the curtain someplace.
Well, I see President Price just standing back there. Okay. Oh, well, she can come on out. She can hear us. And President Price, President Balls, were they having trouble with the assignment, or? All right. We need a lead singer.
He was the first one to move.
We need a tenor. We need a couple of backup singers.
Oh, there she is. Come on up.
Come on up.
The tenor, you'll know when you come in. Okay. Come on up. Hayden, I'll come down. This is an oldie but a goodie. You all know the tune.
I'd like to thank the guy who wrote the song that made my baby fall in love with me. Who put the bump in the bump a bump a bump? Who put the rhyme in the ram-a-lam-a ding dong? Who put the bop in the bop shabop shabop? Who put the dip in the dip di dip di dip? Who was that man? I'd like to shake his hand. He made my baby fall in love with me. When my baby heard bom-ba-ba-bom-ba-bom-ba-bom, every word went right into her heart. And when she heard them singing ram-a-lam-a-lam-a-lam-a-lam-a-ding-dong, she said we'd never have to part. So who put the bop in the bom-ba-bom-ba-bom? Who put the rhyme in the ram-a-lam-a-ding-dong? Who put the bop in the bop shabop shabop? Who put the dip in the dip di dip di dip? Who was that man? I'd like to shake his hand. He made my baby fall in love with me. Each time that we're alone, boogity 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 shoot, sets my baby's heart all aglow. And every time we dance to dip 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 dip, she always says she loves me so. So who put the bop in the bop a bop a bop? Who put the rhyme in the ram a lam a ding dong? Who put the bop in the bop shoo bop shoo bop? Who put the dip in the dip 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 dip? Who was that man? I'd like to shake his hand. He made my baby fall in love with me.
Darling, bom 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 bom, and my honey, ram-a-lam-a ding dong, forever. And when I say dip 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 dip, you know I mean it from the bottom of my boogity 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 shoe.
We hope this is Fifth Ward. That's all that's left.
It better be.
Stay tuned for the Kent Fifth Ward.
All right.
Just sit right back and you'll hear a tale of a fateful trip that started from this tribe aboard this tiny ship. It was a mighty sailor man, skipper brave and sure. Five passengers set sail that day for a three-hour tour. A three-hour tour. The weather started getting rough, the tiny ship was tossed. If not for the courage of the fearless crew, the middle would be lost. The middle would be lost. The ship set down on the shore of this uncharted desert isle. With a millionaire and his wife, a movie star, the professor and Mary Ann, here at Gimmick in Time.
Sorry, my friends, you had not landed on Gilligan's Island. You have just entered the Twilight Zone. This is where all old television shows go when no one can stand to watch them anymore. Enter.
It's a beautiful day in the neighborhood, a beautiful day for a neighbor. Would you be mine? Could you be mine?
They're creepy and they're kooky, mysterious and spooky. They're all together, ooky, the Addams Family.
Sunday, Monday, happy days. Tuesday, Wednesday, happy days. Thursday, Friday, happy days. The weekend comes, my cycle hums, ready to race to you.
Here we come, walk down the street. We get the funniest looks from everyone we meet.
What's that, Lassie? Timmy fell in the well again. What the? Brady Bunch has been captured by little green people? Oh, the Brady Bunch has been captured by Dr. Evil!
Here's the story of a lucky day.
Stop! We don't have time for singing. We have to go rescue the Brady Bunch. Come on!
As you see, all is not well with this happy little crew. You could say they're in the Twilight Zone. Watch what happens next.
Dad, this is so stupid. Why'd you kidnap the Brady Bunch? They're just a bunch of wimps. I'm not with it, Dad.
Here's the story.
Shh!
Right.
Dad, you're not with it. You're not hip.
Okay. So you're saying I'm not hip. I can't chill with my dogs. I'm afraid you're mistaken, Scott. Mini-me. Oh, Mini-me. Scott thinks we're not hip. Come on, Mini-me. Let's dance.
No, no, Dad. Let me show you how it's done.
As I walk through the valley where I harvest my grain, I take a look at my wife and realize she's very plain. But that's just perfect for an Amish like me. You know I shun fancy things like electricity. At 4:30 in the morning I'm milking cows. Jebediah feeds the chickens and Jacob plows. Fool, and I've been milking and plowing so long that even Ezekiel thinks that my mind is gone. I'm a man of the land, I'm into discipline. Got a Bible in my hand and a beard on my chin. But if I finish all of my chores and you finish thine, then tonight we're gonna party like it's 1699. We've been spending most our lives living in an Amish paradise. A churn butter once or twice, living in an Amish paradise. It's hard work and sacrifice, living in an Amish paradise. We sell quilts at discount price, living in an Amish paradise.
Right. Now where was I? you got to get home before dark.
Why?
Come on, people, throw me a bone here. Okay, I get scared of the dark. Is that okay? Is everybody fine with that? Now let's go.
That will solve all of our problems. This little gizmo can change those who are evil into good. It can make the grass greener, the trees.
Can it really do all that?
Well, no. But it's worth a try, guys. Let's go!
As you can see, this is no ordinary story with any ordinary characters doing ordinary things. You could say they're in the Twilight Zone. Watch what happens next.
Guess who's coming to dinner? The Brady Bunch.
Here's the story.
Shh. I'm lovely.
The Brady Bunch? How many times have I told you to call before having company over?
Right.
This place is a mess. Brady Bunch. Please make yourselves comfortable. Dinner will be ready in a moment.
Like, okay.
Okay.
Marsha!
Oh, dear. Dad, this is so stupid.
Shh!
No, Dad, I'm sick of you.
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Shh!
Dad!
Scott, let me tell you a story. When I was a boy, about the... No, no, Mimi! We don't bite our kitties. Not even a little bit. Where did we go wrong with you? Scott, get them.
This is stupid.
You can't run any further. My little gizmo is going to change you from evil to good.
Brady Bunch.
Oh, sure, Dad. I'd love to.
Thank you, Scott.
I love the Brady Bunch.
What is that music?
As you can see...
Hey, who is that?
Anything can happen in the Twilight Zone.
No, no! Mini-me, we do not bite men in black suits. Come on, people. Honestly, now, where was I? Come on, throw me a bone here.
Let's dance.
Here's the story of a lovely lady who was bringing up three very lovely girls. All of them had hair of gold, like their mother, the youngest one in curls. Here's the story of a man named Brady who was busy with three boys of his own. They were four men living all together, yet they were all alone. Till the one day when the lady met this fellow, and they knew that it was much more than a hunt, that this group must somehow form a family. That's the way we all became the Brady Bunch, the Brady Bunch. That's the way we became the Brady Bunch.
Oh, we've asked Sister Cindy Dance to say the closing prayer. While she's coming up, a couple of announcements.
One announcement, remember, please recycle your programs, if you would. We'll have a place on either side of the aisles here to collect them.
And somebody turned in a ring to me. If you lost a ring, come and see me and we'll... No, it doesn't say Dave on it. If you lost a ring, come on up and you can get it. Just a round of applause for all the youth who put on the program.
And our great judges.
And our great judges. All the volunteers who came and helped us. And for all the people and the sound and the lights and the backstage that helped. Please leave your chairs up. We're going to use them again tomorrow. And the presentation of the awards will be this time tomorrow night. Cindy.
Our Father in heaven, we're thankful for this evening. We're thankful for the good time that we had. We're thankful for the youth in our stake and for the talent that they have and that they shared with us. We're thankful for the adults that supported them, and we ask that thou will be with them as they travel to their various destinations, that they will do so in safety. We ask that thou will bless us, that we will be able to return to our homes in safety. And we say these things in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.